في الاتحادية تعليقه على ما على هذا الخطاب.
مفيش تعليق غير دي، مفيش تعليق أكتر من الجزمة لهذا الخطاب. مفيش تعليق غير كده.
طب أستاذ إيهاب تعليق.
لا طبعا أنا كنت أعرف إن محمد مرسي كذاب وملاوع لحد يعني إيه لحظات قليلة، إنما كذاب وملاوع ومجنون بجنون الكرسي والسلطة. هذا الرجل الذي يخرج على شعبه لكي يهدد ويلوح بالعنف يقف علينا رئيس الجمهورية الآن، رئيس الجمهورية السابق المجنون بالسلطة المجنون بالكرسي، هذا الرجل الملاوع الكذاب الخادع وتلك الجماعة التي لا تعرف تلك الجماعة.
طب طب خلاص اشرب ميه اشرب ميه.
اهدى يا استاذ ايهاب،
اهدى اهدى يا استاذ ايهاب، مش كويس كده، اهدى اهدى، معلش معلش. طب اهدى،
هو مش عارف ان هيروح لربنا، مش هلاقي محمد بديع جنبه ولا خيرت الشاطر، هيتدفن في متر في متر، نجيب له ايه اكتر من 33 مليون في الشارع؟ ما بيشوفوش ما بيشوفوش، امي مش عايزين اللي حصل في البلد بسببهم، قعدوا يتكلموا عن مؤامرات، بيكلمني عن ايرادات في الخارج والداخل، هو اللي بعت لي بريد وبعت لي اوباما ويحتمي بيه امريكان. هذا الرجل ما فيش راجل قاعد في الدنيا رئيس جمهورية يطلع عن تعبه يحس انصاره عليه رد، هو عاوز يقتتل صباحا، كل دم حرام كل دم يتعطل حصل حرام. وصعب يا محمد مرسي هاي الظلام يا جماعتي، غير ما يمشي محمد مرسي ما فيش وطن شريف غير ما يقف في الميادين، احنا لو اردنا نخرج الناس للميادين ما كناش هنعرف نخرجهم زي محمد مرسي عمل. ايه العمل ده؟ ايه الجنرال ده؟ دي مؤسسه مؤسسه صاحبه 17 سنه للحضاره، حرام عليهم. ايه الجنان اللي شفناه ده؟ ايه الهبل والجنان ده؟ انا بقول لكل المصريين لو فيكوا راجل شريف بيحب هذا الوطن عليه اللي ينزل الشارع، ما يرجعش غير لما محمد مرسي يمشي. كنا بنقول لحد امبارح او من ساعات عليه أنا إنه هو،
أنا خايفة عليه،
عليه إنه هو
أستاذ إيهاب، أستاذ إيهاب ثواني بس عشان خاطر،
عليه إنه
أنا
هو
خايفة بس عليه
يدعو الانتخابات. هذا الرجل انتهى وجماعته انتهت،
أنا خايفة عليه،
ومصر مقبرة الإرهاب والتطرف انتهت خلاص، أكذوبة الإسلام
عشان أنت عندك القلب يا إيهاب.
ما شفناش راجل منهم من قاداتهم يموت في الشوارع، يطلع هو
كده هتموت كده هتموت كده،
هيبقى في واجد مين؟
ما يستاهل.
مصر شالت فوق طايف خير بمين؟ فين شبابها وفين ولادها المخلصين؟ مصر شالت فوق طايف خير بمين؟
Peace peace family, I'm back with another important exclusive dynamic powerful video. The streets is always watching, we always watching. Even from afar, we can see what's going on. We can peep. So this is what's up. You know, the reason why I showed you that video to let you know us as black people on this planet, we had no friends. The Arab is not your friend. You see the hate that he has for black people, especially us brothers and sisters who are African so-called Americans. You know, people who visit Kemet, going back studying, you know, their history, learning that Egypt or Kemet, you know, was once upon a time inhabited by black people. We gave power to the civilization that they call Egypt, but the real name is Kemet. This Arab, he spews so much hate that he don't even know his history. What he may know it, because a lot of people know what's going on that's in control of Egypt. They know once upon a time it was inhabited with black people who gave rise to the civilization there before it was conquered. Many, many dynasties. From the first dynasty to the 25th dynasty were black people who were fighting different people like the Persians, the Greeks, the Romans. You know, we fought against all different type of tribes. We even fought against the Asians who came in Egypt. So it took many conquests by different people before the Egypt fell to the hands of our enemies. Kemet fell to the hand of our enemies. This hateful Arab don't know his history. He is blind by hate and jealousy. He just got there in 640 AD or 641 AD is when the Egyptians, when the so-called Egyptians, which is the Arabs, got to Egypt. They conquered it from the Romans who fell. And now, the reason why I want to bring this video to your attention to let us as black people to know that the Arabs was the first people who participated in the slave trade. So while we always going in on the white man and European people about slavery, but the Europeans wouldn't know shit about coming into Africa taking black people if it wasn't for the Arabs who introduced the slave trade to Europeans. The Europeans and the Arabs, slavery of black people was on the same level. Same killings, lynching. You know, the Arabs used to castrate black men, period. Castrate them. They were so jealous of the brothers, they castrated them and made them nothing but slaves. Yes. So, right now, where I'm going with this, there's tension in the now, right now, today, because the Ethiopians want to build a dam. Well, they already built the dam. They've been building on this dam since 2011. And this dam cost $4.8 billion to build. It's called the Renaissance Dam. Egypt's proclaiming that the water from the Nile, which started the Blue Nile, because you know the Blue Nile and the White Nile makes the Nile. They hit each other and then they make the Nile, the Blue and White Nile. Well, Ethiopia, up in Ethiopia is where the Blue Nile starts at. So the dam is going to be filled with rain. And Egypt said that the water is going to dry up down in Egypt and they're not going to be able to have a good source of drinking water. But check this out. The Nile runs through 11 countries in Africa. 11 countries in Africa. So I don't know how the irrigation system run over there in Africa. But I do know that this dam that's being built, that's already built, that's about to be, I mean today, because about 2 days ago I checked and it was starting to rain and the dam is about to fill up. But Egypt's been having a gripe about it. They've been going to the UN. They want America to get involved to stop the African Ethiopians from achieving building this dam. This dam is going to be an economic source to put Ethiopians on a playing field with the rest of the country. I mean, with the rest of his neighbors in the region, which is Egypt. Egypt is a racist place for black people. Egypt just do not want the Ethiopians to gain any type of economic power in the land. Egypt wanted to go to war with the Ethiopians over this dam. About 2 days ago, I heard the dam was being filled up with rain. And the Egyptians are really pissed off. So I'm hoping that the Egyptians don't try to hurt the brothers and sisters by trying to drop a bomb or a secret type of weapon, you know, on the brothers and sisters for building the dam. This dam is hydroelectricity damn, they would be able to prescribe, they'll be able to make electricity, you know, for the country. And also, Ethiopia would be able to sell electricity to its neighbors in the region. No one wants to see Africans achieve. But see, it's that time. It's that time. Africans, they're going to achieve. It's our time, man. So, this is what this is all about. Egypt don't give a damn about no water supply being limited in their country, because it won't be. They just don't want to see blacks achieve. I think it's about race. The Egyptian government do not want to see the black Ethiopian government achieve an economic status in the land. The conspiracy is worldwide. They want to keep Africans, black people, at the bottom. They want us always begging them. So, I mean, I may be far reaching with this. Egypt may have an argument. But I think it's all about race. You see with that Egyptian, how he was acting, the fake Egyptian. Well, he can call himself Egyptian, because we didn't call ourselves Egyptians. Egyptian is a Greek name. When Greeks conquered Alexandria, Alexandria really didn't conquer. His men conquered Egypt. Alexandria, I think he died in the Middle East somewhere. Somebody killed him in the Middle East. But they call a city there in Egypt Alexandria, after Alexander the Great. So, yeah, when the Greeks conquered Egypt, that's what they call it, Egypt. It was called Kemet. You know, I think Egypt means people with skin color. You know what I'm saying? Because when the Romans, Greek historians like Herodotus and Aristotle, in their writings, if you go back and look at Aristotle, the Greek philosophers or the Greek historians, if you go back and look at their literature, they'll tell you that the Africans and Kemet were dark skinned. They wasn't light. They wasn't close to European or what the Arab is today, because the Arab, I think he has Roman blood, which is white blood running through his veins. He's closer to the Italian. Of course, the Arabs also mixed their seed with the black woman when they went into different parts of Africa. They conquered the black woman and had a baby by the black woman, but turned the seed against black people. So you have black Arabs, believe it or not, black Arabs, who are half Arab and African, but more of a black hue face, they'd be considered black people here in the United States. They've been taught to hate their mother, where they come from. They've been taught to hate Africans too. That's why I think Sudan is ran by some of them type niggas, and they're Greek. They're in agreement with Egypt that Ethiopia shouldn't allow this dam to be filled with water, but it's gonna be filled with water anyway. The Ethiopians don't give a damn. This is about their sovereignty. This is about their economic plight in the land. They're not gonna back down. Hey man, listen, y'all smash up the likes. Y'all tell me what y'all think in the comments below. Do you think I'm judgmental of Arabs? Cause you see how they treat us in the neighborhood. You know the Arabs in the neighborhood sell us pork, and they supposed to be Muslims, and they wouldn't eat pork themselves, but they stationed in every part of your neighborhood selling you pork. That's deep. Here it is. You a Muslim who following the Sunnah, you a black man, you know that they in violation. But nobody goes to the Arabs and point that out. Listen, you don't eat this yourself. Why you serving this to my community? These Sunni Muslims that are in the line, these black Sunni Muslims who are Orthodox, how come they don't pull up on their so-called Muslim brothers who selling our people poison in the neighborhood? Black people got no friends. Hey, peace out. The streets is always watching. Hey, man, listen, man. Y'all can donate to the channel. You know, we're trying to get this shit, you know, on another level. You know, or y'all can hate on me. I don't care. I'm going to keep on speaking my mind. You know, even though you might not support me, I don't care. I'm going to keep on achieving. Motherfuckers can't stop me, man. I'm going to keep on dropping it like I'm supposed to be dropping it. This the streets, man. And it's watching. You know what I mean? I'm gone, man. But hit the like buttons, man. Hit the like button. Hit the like button. Like my video, share it. You know, I want to get on the level with these other YouTubers. You know, they be having like 400 motherfuckers in the motherfucking chat line, goddammit. Soon as they pop on the goddammit channel. And some of the motherfuckers don't even be talking about nothing. Soon as the fucking channel pop on, motherfuckers is hitting them up. Ain't nobody talking about unifying black people all over the planet but me. I'm the only one. I'm the only one. I'm the only one that's telling black people, no matter what the fuck you believe in, you got to unite up under the Second Amendment. This is why I support the NFAC. This is why I support that brother. Because he's talking about unifying how Africa used to be. When you say Nubian and Kush, you talking about the same people. When you said Nubian, you're talking about the same people. At one time, we called ourselves all Nubians. All 50-some countries in Africa was united as one. The white man came in, the Arabs came in, the Persians came in and separated us. Now they tell history to make it look like we different people. We not the same. And some of these Negroes are falling for it. Look, man, that's another discussion. I'm gone, man. Peace, the streets watching.
ስምምነቱ ለግድቡ መሞላት እንደ ቀድሞ ሁኔታ ከተቀመጠ ግድቡ መቼውንም አይሞላም ማለት ነው። ምን ማለት ነው? ግድቡ ስምምነት ካልተደረሰ አይሞላም ከተባለ ግብጽ ሁልጊዜ ምክንያት እየደረደረች አትስማማም ማለት ነው። ካልተስማማች ደግሞ ግድቡ አይሞላም ማለት ነው። እና ይሄ በጣም ጎጂ የሆነ መርህን ያልተከተለ ነገር ስለሆነ ኢትዮጵያ እንዲህ አይነቱን ሁኔታ ልትቀበለው አትችልም።
Is that the whole time?